because of a new book out there. That's Huffington Post reporter Andy Campbell's new book, We Are Proud Boys. Well, we have now more insight into the right-wing group, even a little explanation on how the group got its name. So we know that the Proud Boys name first came to Gavin McInnes while he watched with disgust as a 12-year-old boy with brown skin sang a musical number on stage at a school recital. How weird is that? And that is Gavin McInnes right there. Yeah, really. All right, so Andy Campbell says this in the book about McInnes. McInnes was pissed that he had to be in the audience at all. He already sat through performances of his son playing the drums and his daughter playing the guitar. And now here was this kid singing a song from a Broadway musical. This little Puerto Rican kid comes out and he goes, "I'll make you proud, boy." It was the gayest effing song. When I was watching, I was like, this is obviously the Hispanic son of a single mom. He did high five a grown man afterward, but I couldn't have, it couldn't have been the real dad. What? Yeah, so this is what Gavin McInnes had said on his show. Wow, racist, classist, ugh, homophobia, run amok, disgusting. So on the podcast, McInnes's producer then played a bit of the song Proud of Your Boy from the Broadway version of Aladdin, which he continued to mock. And this is what he said on the shed. He said, OMG, he was singing an Aladdin song. What a dork. The worst part is I don't think he was gay. I think he was just like, this is a good song and I can really use my effing diaphragm. What is up with this? Gavin McInnes is like a full-fledged adult getting upset because he went to like a children's recital? Are you out of your mind? Well, Campbell concludes the whole incident in his book, writing, "The origin of the Proud Boys, the nation's most notorious political fight club, can be traced to one reactionary bigot behind a microphone who hated a child he figured was a fatherless Puerto Rican. McInnes seems to embrace this characterization through his wife, though his wife is apparently appalled by it." Yeah, I think his wife and any sane, logical person in this world, like, not only is it just absolutely pathetic, it just, there are just isms galore with this. This is a disgusting human being, without a doubt. And as are any individuals who identify with being Proud Boys. Ben?
They call themselves boys because they are boys. It's the only thing I disagree with what you said, Adrienne, calling him a full-fledged adult. This is a full-fledged child. This person that, this is what you're occupying your mind with. This is what you're occupying your time with. Not just to think your mocking thoughts bad enough, but then to go on air and talk about it and mock the choice of a young child singing a song and then name your organization after it. They're a bunch of idiotic, racist bigots. They're homophobic children. And thankfully, this group is being ostracized and finally being held to account. There's not much else to say. It's just disgusting and unreal. This is the person that founded Vice News, and thankfully they disavow him, but how embarrassing for them.
Mm-hmm, absolutely. How are you going to be at like your kid's recital and you're getting all racist and homophobic toward a child who's performing? That is just, that is just beyond me. I do not get it. But then again, that's what these right-wing little militia groups are, and they are indignant about their right to engage in this hate. It's utterly disgusting.